I have with me former German football legend Lothar Matthaus. Thank you so much for talking to us. Let me start by asking you, with the ease with which Germany is playing football at the moment, won the Confederations Cup, is Germany looking good enough to defend the World Cup in Russia next year?
I'm sure we were one of the closest favorites.
Yeah.
But we cannot say we win the World Cup. We are ready to make it again because we have a great team, we have great player, and we have a great coach. He's now 10 years a coach, and still the team is motivated to play under him, and the team is hungry to make this what the German team was doing never, to win two titles in a row.
Who do you think could be your threats?
Brazil is making a very good job in this moment. French is making a very good job. Spain always with a player from Real Madrid and Barcelona, with the experience of them. I think it's a tournament where you have your five, six favorites. Argentina with Messi. With the offense, yes, but they don't have the best defense. I think the balance in Argentina is not like in Brazil, in France or in Germany. For this Messi, yes, but the rest, I think it's not good enough to win the World Cup.
Okay.
And I think the three, four favorites are Spain, France, Brazil and Germany.
Since you mentioned Messi, everyone talks about who's the better player now, Lionel Messi or Cristiano Ronaldo. Who would be your pick?
I think this question, it's not fair for one when you decide for another, because each of these two players has highest quality, guaranteed they score 50, 60 goals every year for the club, for the national team. They are really amazing. I prefer more the style of Messi, but I cannot say Messi is a better player, because the same Ronaldo has his quality, his scores, and his titles.
Since you say that you're a big fan of Messi's style, in the 1986 final, you were man-marking Diego Maradona.
Yes.
So is Messi as good as Maradona? How would you compare the two?
For me, he's good like Maradona, but for the fans, for the football fans in Argentina, Messi has to win first the title with Argentina, what Maradona was doing in 1986. Then he is on the same level. But what Messi was doing the last years, you can look the statistic, his goals, his important goals, like now against Ecuador. He was bringing Argentina alone to the World Cup.
Absolutely.
In Russia. And I think they are on the same level. But when Messi win the World Cup for Argentina, he's one step higher than Maradona.
So he's won a plethora of trophies with Barcelona, of course. But if Lionel Messi, you know, retires without having won a World Cup, does that take any shine away from his career?
Very, very small. Yeah, because I didn't win the Champions League.
Yes.
And after 20 years, everybody's talking, oh, you won everything. But you was two times in the Champions League final, but
That's
you
right.
didn't won the Champions League.
Right.
Yes, this for the fans, for the statistics, and it's a little bit shadow on your big shiny. But I think Messi can live with this, I can live with this, and all the players who didn't want everything can live with this, because we was giving our best, but we have to respect we are not playing alone. We have to respect another team, and sometime was maybe the quality on another side or maybe the luck, doesn't matter. I am happy with my career without the Champions League title, and I am sure when Messi cannot win the World Cup with Argentina, he can be proud of his career.
Since you mentioned clubs, who would you pick as your Champions League favourites this time around?
My favorite is Man City with Guardiola, because they bought with a lot of money very good players. Man City and Paris Saint-Germain are for me the favorites, because they have good player, but they had the same a big investment before the season.
Of course, we have to talk a little bit about Bayern Munich.
Yes.
A bit of chaos in the club with Ancelotti getting sacked a month ago or so. Does it feel like the times when you were playing in, maybe in the 90s when it was called FC Hollywood?
Not FC Hollywood, but many things was not going well like in the years before. And I think Ancelotti was not the right decision for Bayern Munich about his mentality. And he got tired. He was tired. He was not motivate anymore the players. He didn't bring the players behind him. He was pushing the players away from him, especially the key players of Bayern Munich. He lost his main players. He lost his key player.
That's right.
And when you are the coach and the team is playing not for you and more against you and not motivate how they have to be, then you don't have a chance like a coach. And for this was the best, they find a way to go separate. And with Sub Heynckes is coming now, or was coming now, a coach back who know the team, who know the player, who know the mentality of Bayern Munich. And I think with him, after the winter break, we can see a new Bayern Munich phase than in the first 4 months.
Okay. And finally, India, of course, recently had the Under-17 World Cup here. Administratively, it was very successful.
Very nice.
How do you think, and do you think, this can be used as a springboard to develop the sport, especially among young children in the country?
Absolutely. It's a motivation. You have a World Cup in your country. It was Under-17, but I saw the stadium was sold out.
Yes.
We saw it in Europe in the television, and I think this was a first step for India. And FIFA believe them, they can organize. And when FIFA believes something, they have a quality here, they have the base, because for this, the FIFA give this World Cup to India, because a lot of people are living here and the people love football. And this can be the motivation to have a great football future in India.
Thank you so much for talking to us. Thank you.
Welcome.